Welcome back to Tungal College online classes. Hello students, how are you all? In last class you learned postulates of molecular orbital theory. The today's topic is energy level diagram for molecular orbitals. In examination they'll give diatomic molecules like C2, N2, F2, O2 etc. And they'll ask construct the energy level diagram for those molecules like N2, F2, O2 etc. And they will ask write the electronic configuration of that molecule, bond order and magnetic natures of those molecules. So before going to construct the energy level diagram for the different types of diatomic molecules, first we will discuss the electronic configuration of molecule, and the next one is bond order of that molecules, and third one is magnetic nature of that molecule. We'll discuss one by one in detail. Among them, the first one is electronic configuration of molecule, the second one is bond order of the molecule, and the third one is magnetic nature of the molecule. Among them, the first one is electronic configuration. Electronic configuration of molecule. Electronic configuration of molecule. So electronic configuration of molecule is defined as the distribution of electrons among the various molecular orbitals is called as electronic configuration of a molecule. Electronic configuration of molecule is different, electronic configuration of atom is different. In the case of electronic configuration of atoms, what you learn is distribution of electrons into various atomic orbitals. But in the case of atoms, distribution of electrons into various atomic orbitals. But here, distribution of electrons into various molecular orbitals. So let us write the definition. The distribution of electrons among various molecular orbitals is called electronic configuration of molecule is called electronic configuration of molecule. So to write the electronic configuration of molecules, we are dividing the molecules into two categories. In that first case is the molecules which contain less than 14 electrons or less than equal to 14 electrons, the molecules which contains greater than 14 electrons. Let us take some example. I'm taking first one is the molecules with less than or equal to 14 electrons. The molecules with less than or equal to 14 electrons. So example, I'm taking H2 molecule number of electrons is 2, because one hydrogen is, each hydrogen has one electron, two hydrogens is there, two electrons. Then I'm taking HE2 molecule. In H2 molecule, total number of electrons, each helium has 2 electrons. Then total number of electrons in the two heliums is 4 electrons. This has 4 electrons, less than 14. I'm taking Li2. I'm taking B2. Taking C2. If you take example C2, carbon has 6 electrons. 6 plus 6, 12, less than 14. I'm taking N2. N2 has each nitrogen has 7 electrons. 7 plus 7, 14 electrons. Here is equal to 14. H2, HE2, Li2, B2, C2, they have electrons less than 14, and nitrogen has electrons equal to 14. So the molecules with less than or equal to 14 electrons, these are examples. For this case, how do you write the electronic configuration of molecules? First, we have to write the electronic configuration. Sigma 1s is less than sigma star 1s is less than sigma 2s is less than sigma star 2s is less than pi 2px is equal to pi 2py. So these energies will be equal. Is less than sigma 2pz. Sigma 2pz is less than pi star 2p x is equal to pi star 2p y is less than sigma star 2p z. So this is the electronic configuration of molecules with less than or equal to 14 electrons. So how do we apply this electron configuration? You will understand by taking these molecules one by one. We will discuss in detail. They will understand how to apply these electron, how to write these electronic configurations. Very simple thing. Then second case is molecules with greater than or equal to 14 electron. Molecules with greater than equal to greater than 14 or equal to 14 electrons. Greater than equal to simply greater than 14 electron, not equal to. Molecules with greater than 14 electrons. For this case, how do you apply? How do you write the electron configuration? Same, we can write sigma 1s. Same thing we have to write. Just one modification we have to. What is that modification? Is this 2pz we have to write here. This one will be shifted here. This one you can shift to this place. Places you can exchange. You'll get for greater than 14 electrons. So sigma 1s is less than sigma star 1s is less than sigma 2s. As is I'm writing sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s. Sigma star 2s is less than here this 2pz you can write here, this pi 2px pi 2p you can write here, x in this position, so remaining is as it is. Then sigma 2pz is less than this one, you can write this one I wrote first here, this one I'm writing here, this one I write writing in this place. Then pi 2px is equal to pi 2py is less than, we can take a this one allowed, this one you wrote here, next one, next is common, pi star 2p x is equal to pi star 2py, these energies are equal, less than sigma star 2pz. So this is the electronic configuration, this is the electronic configuration we have to apply to the molecules which contain a greater than 14 electrons. Examples, you can take greater than 14 examples. You can take O2 molecule. O2 is an example for greater than 14 because each oxygen has 8 electrons. 8 plus 8, 16. So greater than 14. You can take F2 molecule. F2 also has, each fluorine is 9. 9 plus 9, 18. So F2 has 18 electrons. You can take Ne2 molecule. Ne2. In this case, how many electrons is? Each neon is 10. 10, two atoms is the 10 plus 10, 20. So these molecules have greater than 14 electrons. To this molecules, we have to apply this electronic configuration. To this molecules, less than 14 is there, you have to apply this electronic configuration. So this is the electronic configuration of, this is the order for writing electronic configurations of a molecule. So this is the first one, electronic configuration. Second one is a bond order. Bond order. The bond is defined as the half of the difference between the electrons present in a bonding molecular orbital and anti-bonding molecular orbital is called as a bond order. Write the definition. The half of the difference between electrons present in bonding molecular orbital under anti-bonding, I'm writing here anti-bonding here, under anti-bonding molecular orbitals. Anti-bonding molecular orbitals is called bond order. is called a bond order. So we have the formula to calculate the bond order. Bond order is equal to, we took the half of the difference, half 1/2 into number of electrons present in the bonding molecular orbital, and I'm labeling as NB, electron present in the bonding molecular orbital. NB meaning is electrons present in the bonding molecular orbital, minus NA. N is the number of electrons present in the anti-bonding molecular orbital. So by taking this, we are able to calculate a bond order of any diatomic molecules. If you take any molecule H2, He2, Li2 or O2, F2, any molecule take, how many number of bonds between them we are able to find out. Bond order is nothing but how many number of bonds present between the two atoms in a molecule. So how many number of bonds present between the two atoms in a molecule can be calculated by half into NB minus NA. Now one condition is there, if NB is greater than NA, if NB is greater than NA, NB is greater than, in the sense the value will be taken as this value is a positive, will get that means a stable molecule. Molecule is a stable molecule will get it. Stable molecule. If NB is less than NA, or second case is NB is equal to NA, both are equal. This case will get a negative value, or in this case will get a, this case will get a negative value. In these two conditions, molecule is unstable. Molecule is unstable. If NB is greater than NA, in this case only positive value will get, the molecule is stable. If NB is less than NA and NB is equal to NA, in such case the molecule is unstable, we have to consider. So NB is nothing but number of electrons present in a bonding molecular orbital. So this NA represents the number of electrons present in the antibonding. While applying to these molecules, you'll get a much clarity. Just I'm giving the formulas how to find out the bond order of a molecule. This is the bond order of molecules. Next, magnetic nature, third one. Magnetic nature. So we have diamagnetic substances as well as paramagnetic substances. Then the first one is diamagnetic nature. If all molecular orbitals doubly occupied in a substance, the substance is diamagnetic in nature. So already we know very well that molecular orbital, I'm taking the form of a box. Imagine this is the molecular orbital. This molecular orbital filled with two electrons, doubly occupied like this. If two electrons is there in the molecular orbital, that substance is a diamagnetic in nature. Apart from it, only one single electron is present in the substance. So only one singly occupied, one or more molecular orbitals are singly occupied like this, we have to take them as a paramagnetic. So this is a diamagnetic substances, this is a paramagnetic substances. So first, regarding the diamagnetic substances, if all molecular orbitals are doubly occupied, the substance is diamagnetic. If all the molecular orbitals doubly occupied, I'm writing the box here like this, two electrons present in a molecular orbital, doubly occupied, the substance is a diamagnetic nature. This is the first case. And the second case is a paramagnetic nature. So what is a paramagnetic nature? If one or more molecular orbitals are single electron is present like this, then those substances exhibit a paramagnetic nature. If one or more molecular orbitals one or more molecular orbitals singly. Singly occupied, one or more molecular orbitals singly occupied with electrons like this. I'm representing like this. The substance is a paramagnetic nature. And one more important point is diamagnetic substances are repelled by magnetic field, paramagnetic substances are attracted by magnetic field. So paramagnetic substances are attracted by magnetic field. So this is the three points, these are the three points we have tried after construction of molecular orbital energy level diagram. First we'll take one molecule, and for that molecule first we have to construct the molecular orbital energy level diagram. After constructing the energy level diagram, how do we will discuss by one in detail. After construction of the molecular orbital energy level diagram, then first we have to write the electronic configuration of that molecule. Then we have to write we have to find out the bond order between the two atoms, how many number of bonds between the two atoms. After that we have to find out magnetic nature of that molecule. So in examination directly sometimes they will ask write the electronic configuration of this molecule, electron configuration of O2 molecule, F2 molecule or N2 molecule, etc. So directly they will ask bond address, sometimes they will ask magnetic natures. So these are also very important. Now let us discuss energy level diagrams for these molecules with molecules with less than or equal to 14 electrons and molecules with greater than 14 electrons. These examples we'll discuss one by one, and you should understand for one example the remaining all molecules are similar concept. If you understand for one molecule and the remaining concept is same pattern, we have to follow the remaining molecules also. Now let us discuss the construction of energy level diagram for some diatomic molecules. First I'm taking the molecules with less than or equal to 14 electrons. Example I'm taking a H2 molecule. So first I'm taking a H2 molecule, this has less than 14 electrons. Then first we have to write electronic configuration of atoms. Hydrogen electronic configuration is 1s1. There are two hydrogens, so this one also I wrote as a 1s1. First step, I wrote I took the molecule, I wrote electronic configurations, and I took atoms again here. So this is the first hydrogen and this is the second hydrogen. I took two hydrogens side by side here like this. Then I wrote electronic configuration of this hydrogen is 1s1, then this hydrogen configuration is 1s1, clear. Then we have to write orbital box, orbital diagram for this 1s orbital. I wrote orbital box of this 1s orbital. So this orbital diagram for this 1s orbital. This atomic orbital combines with this atomic orbital form molecular orbital. How many atomic orbitals are combining? 1, 2. Two atomic orbitals are combining, how many number of molecular orbitals must form? 2 molecular orbitals. This is the method to write molecular orbitals, and I wrote one molecular orbital here and I wrote one molecular orbital on the top. So this is one atomic orbital, this is another atomic orbital. Atomic orbitals are combined to form two molecular orbitals. The bottom one is called as a bonding molecular orbital. This one is a bonding molecular orbital, bonding MO. This one top one is called as a anti-bonding molecular orbital. Anti-bonding molecular orbital. So we have to label them. Bonding in the sense we have to type as a sigma. How many, what is orbital? It is 1s. This is sigma 1s orbital. This is a sigma 1s, but anti-bonding in the sense we have to put as a star. So star is not there, that is bonding. If you keep sigma star or pi star, they are anti-bonding. So bottom one is a bonding, top one is a anti-bonding. So this is a energy order. This is energy order. Bonding is lower energy, anti-bonding is higher energy. Right. Now coming to the point. Here is this atomic orbital has one electron. Fill electrons in it. First I fill this electron, and I'm filling electron this 1s orbital. So after filling of electrons in 1s orbital, then we have to this one electron, this electron will be, we have to fill in a molecular orbital. Atoms combined with this atom, they forming H2. These are the molecular orbital. How many number of electrons is there? 1, 2. So first we have to fill in the lower energy state. Then after completion of the 2 electrons here, we have to go to higher energy state. Here is 2 electrons is there. We have to first fill electrons in the lower energy state here. Then we have to go to upside. Then how many? 1, 2. If third electron is there, we have to fill here. Third electron is not there, so that here is 2 is enough, we have to fill. So this is the filling of electrons. This is the construction of energy level diagram for H2 molecule, clear. Then we have to write 3 points. The first one is electronic configuration. So we have to write electronic configuration. Simply we have to arrange this molecular orbital from bottom to top, from here to here, from top bottom to top, we have to write. Then first what is orbital we have? Sigma 1s, and how many number of electrons is there? 1, 2 electrons is there. Sigma 1s2, that's it. If this also contains electrons, we will write here, but here electrons is not there, no need to write. Only 2 electrons is there. Sigma 1s2 is electronic configuration of H2 molecule. Then second one is a bond order. The second point is we have to find out a bond order. What is the formula? Bond order is equal to half into number of electrons in the bonding molecular orbital minus number of electrons in antibonding molecular orbital. This is the formula. This is the bonding molecular, I am labeling as this is Na. This is what? Nb. Number of electrons, these electrons are number of electrons in bonding molecular orbital. This is number of electrons, here is antibonding molecular orbital. This is Na, antibonding, this is Nb, bonding this one. Right, that is equal to half into number of electrons in the bonding. How many? 1, 2. So 2 minus number of electrons in the antibonding. How many is there? No electrons is there. We have to take it as 0. That is equal to 2/2. That is equal to 1. This indicates that one bond is present. The number of bonds between the 2 hydrogen atoms is 1. Bond order one meaning is between the 2 atoms there is one single bond is present. Then this is a point number 3. And one more point here is bottom one is the bonding, top one is the antibonding. Bonding home electrons is 1, 2, I wrote 2, here is 0, so that no electrons is, I made it as 0. So we will get bond order is equal to 1. Next one is magnetic nature. So what is the magnetic nature of this H2 molecule? Is it a diamagnetic or it is a paramagnetic? How do you identify it? So if orbital box has a doubly occupied like this, 2 electrons either, we have to call it as a diamagnetic. If orbital box has at least one unpaired electron, one single electron is there, we have to call it as a para. Singly occupied, one electron in the box, so that means orbital diagram paramagnetic. Doubly occupied, 2 electrons present in the box, that means orbital diagram that is diamagnetic. Look at here, how many electrons? 1, 2 electrons. This is a 2 electrons, here is no electrons is there. So doubly occupied in the sense this is what? Diamagnetic. So H2 molecule is a diamagnetic in nature. This is a construction of a molecular energy level diagram for H2 molecule. Then we can take one more example for a better understanding. Example 2, I am taking Helium 2 molecule, this one. So first what we have to do? We have to write electronic configuration. First step, 1s2, 2 electrons is there. Take another atom also, write electron configuration, this also 1s2. Then what we have to do? These orbitals we have to arrange from top to bottom. So I am taking helium here, one helium take here, and I am taking another helium here, 2 heliums I took. And writing electron configuration 1s2, I am writing this electron configuration is 1s2. I am writing a orbital diagram for this 1s2, I am writing orbital diagram for this 1s2. So I wrote orbital diagrams. Then this atomic orbital combined with this atomic orbital form how many molecular orbitals? 2. One is there, here is one, the total is, we have to make 2 molecular orbitals. right? So one is bonding, another one is anti-bonding. So we have to label it. What is this? 1s only. This is a sigma 1s. This is also what? Sigma 1s. So this is sigma star. Anti-bonding is sigma star. Sigma 1s, sigma star 1s. I labeled it. Then this is the energy order. Next, what we have to do? We have to fill the electrons. We have to fill electrons in these molecular orbital and atomic orbitals. How many electrons is there? 2, 1, and this is the second one. This case, how many? 1s2, 1, this is the second electron. Clear. Then we have to fill these electrons in a molecular orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons is there. Then first we have to fill in a lower energy state, then we have to go to higher energy state. So 1, 2, doubly occupied. 3, 4. So it is also doubly occupied. So this is the filling of electrons in molecular as well as atomic orbitals. Then we have to write 3 points. First one is electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. Electronic configuration of He2 molecule. Then what is the first? We have to arrange from bottom to top. Here is sigma. Sigma 1s. How many number of electrons is there? 1, 2. So sigma 1s2. Then this is completed. Then we have to go to top one. Less than sigma star. How many? What is this? 1s. How many number of electrons is there? 1, 2. Sigma star 1s2. Sigma 1s, sigma star 1s. This is a number of electrons 2 plus 2, 4. This is electronic configuration of He2 molecule. Then second one is a bond order. The second one is a bond order. So bond order is equal to half into Na minus Nb. Number of electrons in the bonding molecular orbital minus number of electrons in anti-bonding molecular orbital. Now look at this. Half into number of electrons in the bonding molecular orbital. How many is there? 1, 2. 2 electrons is there. This is not bonding. This is anti-bonding. This is anti-bonding molecular orbital. This is bonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital. So in bonding molecular orbital, how many is there? 2 electrons. So 2 minus anti-bonding, how many is there? 1, 2 electrons. 2 minus 2. That is equal to, we will get 0. 0 bond order represents no, the bond not formed between two He2 molecule, there is no bond. In between the He and He, two He atoms, in between them there is no bond formation. Bond is not formed. There is no bond formation indicates what the molecule does not exist. So already we know noble gases do not react with any other element. So helium is belongs to the noble gas. Helium do not react with any other element, even with helium itself. So that these are not react with any element is because of its this bond order is zero. It do not form any bonds. So bond order zero in the sense, this case I'm talking about, this case bond order zero in the sense, bond order zero in the sense the molecule does not exist. He2 molecule does not or do not exist. Bond order is equal to 0. He2 molecule do not exist. He2 molecule is not there. So this is a construction of a molecular orbital energy level diagram for He2 molecule. Even this case what we did is first we took atoms, we wrote electronic configuration, so we arranged, we took the atoms at the down and we arranged electronic configuration from bottom to top like this, and we wrote then we wrote orbital diagrams. So we combining them, atomic orbitals are combining to form molecular orbitals. We wrote electronic configuration, bond order and magnetic nature of the compounds. This is a second example. Next example, I'm taking a C2 molecule. Next example is C2 molecule. So first what we have to write electronic configuration of two carbons. So first I'm taking carbon 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. I'm taking another carbon here itself. Its carbon is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So I wrote first electronic configuration of each atom. Then I'm taking one carbon here. This is one carbon I'm taking here. I'm taking another carbon here. atoms. Then we have to write electron configuration from bottom to top. First this carbon I'm writing 1s2, then 2s2, next we have 2p2. I wrote electronic configuration of one carbon, I wrote. Then take second carbon, this is 1s2, for this carbon 2s2 2p2. I wrote electronic configurations of elements. Then what we have to do, we have to write orbital diagrams. This is orbital diagram for this one, this is the orbital diagram for this electron. Then atomic orbitals combine to form molecular. How many combining? 1, 2 combining. How many will get? 2. This is the carbon. Right, coming to the point. So this is one molecular orbital and this is another molecular orbital. We have to label it. What is this orbital? 1s. This will be taken as a sigma 1s. This we will label as a sigma star 1s. In these two, this is a bonding, this is the antibonding, one complicated. Then coming to the second case, 2s2 case. Right, so this is a 2s2, this is also a 2s2. Then here you'll get one bonding and he'll get another antibonding. Clear? So what is this we have to label? This is a sigma, what is this orbital? 2s orbital. This is sigma 2s. What about this one? Sigma star 2s. Sigma 2s, sigma star 2s. I labeled it. Then coming to the 2p2. So 2p2 says we have 3p orbitals, px, py, pz. Here also we have 3p orbitals. What are they? Px, py, pz. This is 2p2, px, py, pz. How many atomic orbitals is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. So how many number of molecular orbitals you can expect? 2 is combined, 2 is formed. Then 6 is combining, 6 is going to get a form. How many number of atomic orbitals are combining? That many number of molecular orbitals are formed. Equal number. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, totally 6. So we have to write 6 here. Right, so here is 2 I'm writing at the bottom and 1 is at the here. I wrote 1, 2, 3. Then 1 here I wrote second one, last one. So this is the total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many number of atomic orbitals are combining? That many number of molecular orbitals are formed. This point is clear. Then we have to label them. These are the bonding, this diagram I'm talking, these are the bonding, these are the antibonding. Bonding is 3, antibonding is 3. So this is a pi 2px, p orbital divided into px, py, pz. So pi 2px, this one I'm labeling as a pi 2py. This I labeled as a pi 2pz. This is sigma 2pz, pi 2px, pi 2py, sigma 2px, this case completed, bonding, antibonding, pi 2px become, this will become pi star 2px, this is pi star 2py, what about this one, this is a sigma star 2pz, sigma star 2pz, I labeled it, so labeling is simple. So sigma 1s, what is this? Sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, 2s orbital, sigma 2s, sigma star 2s. This is a p orbital, we have two types. One is a px, py, pz. So pi 2px, pi 2py, sigma 2pz. Antibonding is pi star, pi will become pi star, this pi will become pi star, this sigma becomes sigma star. Antibonding is star, sigma star, pi star, bonding is pi and sigma individual. So this step is completed. This is the energy order, energy increasing order. Then what the next step we have to, fill these orbitals with the electrons coming to here. So how many electrons is there? 1, 2 electrons is there. Here also how many is there? 1, 2 electrons is there. Total 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to fill these molecular orbitals with 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I filled. This completed. Coming to here. 2s2, 2s2. Number of electrons is 1, 2. 2s2, 2 electrons here also. 2 electrons. 1, 2. 2 electrons is there. Then total number of electrons 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 we have to fill here. 1, 2. First we have to fill in the bottom, then we have to go to antibonding. 3, 4. This is filled. Coming to this case, how many number of electrons? 2 electrons is there. I am labeling as this is the 1, this is the 2. Here I am labeling as this is the first, you can take anywhere, you can take, no problem. Taking here 1, this is the 2. You can take like this, no problem. And this is the 1, this is the 2. So px, py, pz orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons is there. Then we have to fill 1, 2, 3, 4. First we have to fill the lower energy state. This one we have to fill because they are equal in energy. So pi 2 px is equal to pi 2 pl. First 1, 2, 3, 4. According to principles, is there now above principle, then we have to follow Hund's rule, then we have to follow Hund's rule and Pauli's exclusion principle. These three principles we have to fill, to fill the electrons in a molecular orbital. So 4 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth electron is there, fifth will come here. 5, 6. 7 is there, 7 will come here. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and so on. So this is a filling of electrons in a molecular orbitals and atomic orbitals. Then step first one, electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. So these are very simple. If you follow for one or two molecules, if you practice yourself, then automatically without preparation also you're able to do construct these molecules. Very simple. Any molecule you can able to construct. So very simple things. Then electronic configuration. How do you get electronic configuration? Simply arrange these atom molecular orbitals increasing lower from top, bottom, from bottom to top. First you can write 1s, then 2s. This is the lower energy, next this is higher energy. Next higher energy. So from bottom to top, energy is going to get increases. First we have to write in lower energy, then we have to go to higher energy. First lower energy, sigma 1s. How many electrons is there? 1, 2. Sigma 1s2 less than. Next, after this, what we have? Sigma star 1s. How many electrons is there? 1, 2 less than. Here come to here, sigma 2s. Next we have sigma 2s. How many number of electrons here? 1, 2. Sigma 2s2 less than. After this, first we wrote 1, this one after this one, this one after this one. After this one we have to go to here. Then sigma star 2s. How many electrons is there? 1, 2. Clear. Less than pi 2px pi 2py equal. So here is 2. Then we will write pi 2px. How many electrons is there? Pi 2px. 1, 2 electrons is there. Pi 2px2 that is equal to pi 2py. How many electrons is there? 1, 2. So this is a electronic configuration of a C2 molecule. Then second one is what? Bond order. What is the formula? By is equal to half into number of electrons in the bonding minus number of electrons in anti-bonding. Now count it, half into number of electrons in the bonding. Which is the bonding? This is the bonding. For these two, for this diagram, this is the bonding. 1, 2 electrons. For this diagram, this is the bonding, this is the anti-bonding. For this diagram, this is the bonding, these are the anti-bonding. So now count bonding, these are the two. Here is 2 electrons in the bonding, 2. Plus this is the bonding. I'm rounding up border the bonding. This is the bonding, 2 electrons. This is the bonding, 2 electrons. These are the bonding, 2 2 electrons. Here is 4. Bonding, this is the bonding, this is the bonding. This is antibonding, antibonding, antibonding. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. 8 is there, 8 minus antibonding. This is antibonding and this is antibonding. Antibonding, how many is there? 2, here antibonding is 2. 2 plus 2, 4. Antibonding is 4. That is equal to half into, how many will get? 4. That is equal to 2. The bond that 2 indicates that between the 2 carbon atoms, so there is a double bond. Between the 2 carbon atoms, so there is a double bond. Bond order meaning is a number of bonds between the 2 atoms. So there is a double bond between 2 carbons. Next, third one, magnetic nature. Magnetic nature. In magnetic nature, we have to find out diamagnetic or paramagnetic. Diamagnetic in the sense, doubly occupied, this is dia. Singly occupied, this is para. Check it. Here is doubly occupied. Here is doubly occupied. Here is 2 electrons doubly occupied. Here is 2 electrons doubly. This is doubly, this is doubly. No single electron in the molecular orbital. No singly occupied and all are doubly occupied. The substance is diamagnetic. The substance is diamagnetic. So this is a construction of molecular orbital energy level diagram for C2 molecule. So these are very simple. And first we have the electronic configuration, bond order and magnetic nature. This is the way of the construction of a molecular energy level diagram for any molecule, diatomic molecule, and electrons less than equal to 14. So next topic, next class I'll come out with the continuation topic of energy level diagram for construction of molecular orbital energy level diagram for electrons with greater than 14.